Twitter is unveiling a new feature that encrypts some direct messages between users.
X, the platform formerly known as Twitter, is one of the most widely used messaging services in the world, with nearly 500 million users as of summer 2023. They say that they seek to be the most trusted platform on the internet, and encrypted direct messages are an important part of that. So this year, X went ahead and launched this encrypted messaging feature. In this video, I'll walk you through how to use it, go over who's eligible to use this service, and then explore whether or not you should use it, which will depend on what exactly your threat model is. In general, if you're going to send messages on a certain platform anyway, and they give you the option of using a more private way to do so, you should probably take it. But then I'm going to take a deep dive into the weeds of how X has actually implemented their private messaging. There are some big concerns about how private it actually is, and we explain why we don't think it's a good option for sending anything sensitive. So let's get started by first understanding what X means when they say encrypted messages. Encryption is a broad term that can mean very different things. When X mentions encryption in this context, they're referring to end-to-end encryption for DMs, which is where only the sender and recipient of a message can read its contents.
If you are in a conversation you think is sensitive, you can just toggle encryption on, and then no one at Twitter can see what you're talking about. They could put a gun to my head and I couldn't tell it.
With normal DMs, X employees can actually read everything we say through their internal portal with the click of a button. Being able to access what we'd probably consider private conversations is actually normal practice from major tech companies. Gmail reads the contents of all our emails. Facebook can see the contents of our direct messages by default. Microsoft looks through the contents of all our cloud documents. This kind of pervasive digital surveillance has become normalized. But it shouldn't be normalized. And X is taking a stand by choosing to put certain user data out of their own reach. Even though your private messages pass through X's servers to get from sender to recipient, end-to-end encryption, when implemented correctly, means that no one at X will be able to decrypt them. Privacy is essential for a free society because it allows us to dissent and push back against authoritarianism without fear of reprisal. So this is a fantastic move from them, upgrading a platform used by hundreds of millions of people with a more private communication option. But the impact is even bigger than this. As one of the largest tech companies in the world, they have also signaled to the rest of the industry and to their users that privacy is important and normal. Good on them for pushing the privacy conversation forward. So how do you use this new feature? First, find the account of the person you want to DM and click the message icon. In the top right-hand corner, you'll see an eye icon. Click that. If you're able to send an encrypted DM to them, you'll have the option Start an encrypted message. Click that, and you've initiated an end-to-end encrypted DM. You'll be able to see which messages are encrypted and which are not, because the encrypted ones will have a lock icon badge on the avatar of the user you're talking to, which will show up in both the inbox and the conversation views. And that's it, pretty straightforward. Now, you might not actually see this option in your messages yet. So let's go over who's currently eligible for this feature.
Only paying subscribers to Twitter Blue can use the feature, and it can only be used between two individuals, not groups.
Both members participating in the conversation need to be Twitter Blue accounts. And you can send another Twitter Blue subscriber an encrypted message if they already follow you, or if they have connected with you via DMs before. Finally, you have to be using the latest version of X. Now the big question, should you use X's new encrypted messages? Let's summarize the pros and cons. The first downside to address, and most important one I think, is that in its current implementation, X would theoretically be able to intercept and read your messages without you ever being notified. We dive into details later about how all of this works exactly. Second, they don't have a feature that we think is crucial for a private messenger called perfect forward secrecy. Again, we dive into details later on about exactly what this is, but basically it means that if someone were to get hold of your conversation key, they could unlock the entire history of messages in that conversation, which isn't great. Having perfect forward secrecy would protect against this, but X doesn't ever plan to implement it. Third, X's encrypted messenger is not open source. So even if they claim to have robust privacy, there's no way to scrutinize that they're doing what they say they're doing. The information we currently have about their setup is only available because researchers were able to reverse engineer some of the code. And finally, they're yet to undergo audits for their encrypted messenger. Because of these downsides, we advise caution in relying on X for high-stakes communications. If you're sharing sensitive information, it's safer to use encrypted messaging apps like Signal, which is open source, has perfect forward secrecy, and is often recommended by security experts as one of the most private encrypted messaging options. Now, here's why you shouldn't completely disregard X's encrypted messenger. As we mentioned, typical direct messages on X can be easily accessed by its employees. The encrypted messaging feature adds a critical layer of protection against this. While it remains technically feasible for X to single out and intercept specific encrypted conversations, this isn't the default practice. For everyday chats, it's far better to opt for X's encrypted messaging than leave your communications fully transparent to X's staff. X's end-to-end encrypted DMs are better than nothing. So if you're using X to DM people anyway, opt for encrypted DMs when you can. So now let's really dive into the nitty-gritty of how X's encrypted messages work and why we think it's not the best option for more sensitive conversations. We mentioned earlier that the Signal app is what we would recommend in those situations. Underpinning the Signal app is the open source Signal protocol developed by Open Whisper Systems, which is generally regarded as the gold standard encryption protocol for private messaging. It's highly regarded because it implements some really sophisticated technology for protecting privacy, and so a whole bunch of different platforms use it in their own private messaging implementation. It was originally thought that X2 would utilize the Signal protocol in their implementation, but that ended up not being the case. Unfortunately, what they have coded up is starkly inferior, and we'll compare some aspects between the two. First, here are some broad strokes of the mechanics of encrypted messages. To encrypt something in a way that only the sender and recipient can read, you'll usually use something called AES, which stands for Advanced Encryption Standard, and is a symmetric encryption algorithm. Sounds super complicated, so just think of it like a lock that has a key. Both the sender and the recipient of a message use the same key to lock and unlock a message. But how do you make sure that both people have the key without anyone else grabbing it? You can't just send them the key when you send them your message. It's like sending someone a locked safe in the mail and sending them the key to the safe in the same package. Anyone could intercept it and just unlock the safe. So that's where a pretty cool concept called asymmetric encryption comes in. You have a lock, but there are two different keys. One key does the locking, and the other key is needed to do the unlocking. These two keys are referred to as an asymmetric key pair. You locked something with the public key, but you can only unlock it with the private key. It's helpful because you can broadcast your public key to everyone, and they use this to lock up messages for you. But you don't tell anyone your private key, and only the private key can actually unlock these messages. From reverse engineering their code, researchers found that X uses both AES and asymmetric encryption to protect messages. The underlying message is protected with AES, generating what you can call a conversation key. If someone gets access to the conversation key, they can read the entire conversation history, so you want to make sure that the key is kept really safe. So this conversation key is protected using asymmetric encryption. It's locked using the recipient's public key and can only be unlocked using their private key. If anyone tries to intercept this conversation key, they won't be able to access it without the right private key that only the recipient controls. While the conversation key is tied to a specific conversation, the public and private asymmetric key pair protecting this conversation key is actually tied to a specific pair of devices. What this means is that basically, X has each person on either side of a conversation each generate an asymmetric key pair on one of their devices. Only these devices that have this private key locally stored on it will be able to unlock the conversation key and participate in the conversation. So for example, I'd only be able to participate in this conversation on my phone or my laptop, but not both, and definitely no one else's devices. only the device that has the private key. This helps keep the conversation key really safe. Using AES and asymmetric encryption is a really clever system that is often used for encrypted messages. But in X's current implementation, they've missed out some important steps. While your private key stays on your device, the public part of the key pair gets uploaded to X and goes into their lookup registry. This way, if anyone wants to send you an encrypted message, they'll look up your public key in the registry and lock the message using that key. Only you will be able to unlock this message using your private key. But what's to stop X just switching out the registered public key associated with the device to one where they hold the private key, or stop them from adding an entirely new device to a user's account? Well, usually with this kind of encryption, there are safeguards built in to stop this. For example, in the original code X wrote that was reverse engineered by researchers, it seemed that if the key pair associated with the ID were switched out, the user would be notified. Great, that way you could see if your asymmetric key pair had been changed and someone else's device could get access to your conversation. But when end-to-end encrypted messages were actually launched by X, the code that existed to notify users that device identity had changed does not appear to have been enabled. This means that in its current form, X can absolutely man-in-the-middle conversations and read your messages, and you'll have no idea. The way this would work is that this conversation key would instead be encrypted using the new asymmetric key pair, and X would have the private key needed to decrypt these messages. So they'd be able to get the conversation key and could now decrypt every message in that conversation, including one sent before the key was obtained. This is a huge deal. By comparison, on Signal, if you associate a new device with your account, you'll get a notification saying your safety number has changed. It's a super important safeguard to prevent someone intercepting your messages. X says that they do indeed plan to add safety numbers and signature checks to their platform. It just hasn't been done yet. If this is done, it will be a huge improvement to the safety of their encrypted messages. But it's worth noting that despite their promises, no new development seems to have been done to encrypted messages since launch. Another thing that the Signal protocol does is use perfect forward secrecy. It's an extra layer of safeguards that says that even if you get hold of someone's conversation key, you won't be able to read the entire conversation history. You'll only be able to decrypt messages going forward since intercepting the key. As we mentioned, this is something that X never plans to implement, which makes it starkly inferior to the Signal protocol. Although all of this gets super complicated, to reiterate our takeaway from this, we don't think that you should use X's encrypted messenger for sensitive conversations. You should opt for a more robust encrypted messenger. While we think that there are much better encrypted messengers out there, if you must use X's DMs for something, using the encrypted option not only boosts your privacy, but also sends a clear message back to X saying that you value privacy. It's early stages for X's end-to-end encrypted messages, and there are some quirks to work out. And while I wish encrypted DMs were available for everyone, X's introduction of this feature is a great first step. It not only brings privacy to a lot more people, but is also a signal to the entire tech industry that privacy is important. Maybe if enough people show support, other platforms will follow suit. By voting with our choices, we can help encourage a more private world.
The choice is yours alone.
I want to do it.
NBTV is funded by community donations. If you'd like to support our free educational content, please visit nbtv.media/support and take a look at our book, Beginner's Introduction to Privacy, that also supports our channel. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and let us know in the comments whether you plan to use X's encrypted DMs. Thank you so much for watching through till the end. Here's my addendum to this video, because I know some of you watch till the very end, and I can tell because you always mention it in the comments, and I always love it. So my unscripted takeaway: we've hated on Telegram in the past because nothing is encrypted by default, and we've said this is not private. The same thing applies to Twitter, right? This is not private by default, but the option is there. If you use the actual encryption of either of these, it's going to be way better than using just transparent messages on either of these. But if you want to send something really sensitive, we really do recommend that you use a better product. So that's the TLDR. You could have just skipped to the end.